you enough. Woo! I owe you my life. Can't praise you enough. Even if I try, 'cause so good, Lord, you've been so good. Say, Lord, you've been so good to me. Oh, Lord, you are good. You've been
so good.
Say, Lord, you are good. You've been better than good. I can't praise you. I owe you my life. I can't praise you. Even if I tried, 'cause you've been so good. Say, Lord, 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 you've been so good. Hallelujah. Lord, you've been so good. Say, Lord, you've been so good to me. So many doors you've opened, so many ways you made, so many times you healed me. You've been better than good to me. So many doors you've opened, so many ways you made, so many times you healed me. You've been better than good. So many doors, so many ways. So many times you've been better than good to me. So many doors, so many ways, so many times you've been better than good to me. So many doors, woo! So many ways, so many times you heal me, God. You've been better than good to me. So many doors, so many ways, oh God. So many times, you've been better than good to me. 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 Woo! You've been better than good to me. You've been better than good to me. You've been better than good to me. Lord, you've been. Woo! You've been better than good. You've been better than good. Hallelujah. You've been better than good. You've been better than good. When I look back over my life and I've seen the ways you made, you've been better than good. Woo! You've been better than good. When I've seen how faithful you've been, when I've seen how you let your mercy ride, you've been good. Say, you've been good. Without you on my side, I wouldn't be standing here today. You've been better than good to me. Woo! You've been better than good to me. When I should be in my grave, all my better than good to me. Woo! You've been better than good to me. You've been better than good to me. You've been better than good to me. When I felt like that I was gonna fall all to pieces, Lord, you held me all together. You've been better than good to me. When I wanted to throw in the towel and I wanted to give it all up, you kept me going, oh God. You've been better than good to me. Every day of my life, you woke me up in my right mind. Every day of my life, you kept me, oh God. You've been better than good. You've been better than good. You've been better than good. You've been so good. You've been so good. The testimony that God has been so good, you ought to lift up a praise unto the Lord. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! We thank you, oh God. Hallelujah! We praise your name, oh God, because you've been a good God. Hallelujah!
Come on, lift them up. Come on, lift them up. Glory, hallelujah. Come on. Come on, if you know he's worthy. The first Sunday in 2022, you're able to give God praise and plant a seed in the upcoming year. And I'm going to tell you again, praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Certainly, he is worthy of all the praise. We thank and we praise God for his goodness. We thank the Lord, amen, for being able to come into the house of God one more time. And amen, we know, amen, the roads are still a little bit challenging. And someone had called and said, Pastor, are we going to have service? And I said, well, I'm not going to force those who want to come, amen. But for those who can make their way to the house of the Lord, amen, this is the first Sunday in 2022. I don't know about you, but I want my year to start off right. I want my year to start off in the presence of the Lord. So as the psalmist said, I was glad when they said unto me, tell your neighbor, that's me, that's me. Let us go into the house of the Lord. Amen. And we bless God, amen, for his goodness. Once again, amen, I give God the glory. I give God the honor, amen, for allowing us to cross over into the new year. And I praise the Lord also for the brothers this morning when they found out. I was like, yes, we're still going to have service, amen. We're going to be online. And the brothers got down here this morning before I got here, Deacon Marcus, Elder Dennis, and Minister Walden. They were shoveling the sidewalk. So I thank God for them. Amen. Amen. And want to invite your attention quickly as we move into the word of the Lord on this first Sunday in 2022 to Paul's letter to the saints of Philippi, Philippians chapter 3, verse 12 through 16. Amen. We're so grateful. God has been good to allow us to cross over into a brand new year. Philippians chapter 3, verse 12 through 16. Father, we honor you and we give you glory. We give you praise for who you are. We thank you for the privilege and just the awesomeness to be able to experience life in you, Father. Being able to be here this first Sunday, giving you praise, Father, and proclaiming the truth of your word. I pray even now that you would open up the ears, Lord God, even now the listeners, those who are tuning in online. We're grateful to God for all those, Father, who are able to still worship with us on today, Lord God. And we pray even now that you would allow these lips of clay, Father, to be used for your glory and for your honor as we start this year. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Philippians chapter 3, verses 12 through 16, and the word of the Lord declares unto us this day, not that I already attain or am already perfected, but I press on that I may lay hold of that for which Christ Jesus has also laid hold of me. Brethren, I do not count myself to have apprehended, but one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things which are ahead, I press toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. Therefore, let us, as many as are immature, have this mind. And if anything you think otherwise, God will reveal even this to you. Nevertheless, to the degree that we have already attained, let us walk by the same rule and let us be of the same mind. And the people of God said, amen and amen. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, God is calling us to move forward. Moving forward. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. And as we watch night service, as the Lord gave us that thematic thrust for this year of 2022, and as we were preaching on watch night service and talking about, amen, the exodus of the children of Israel, crossing the Red Sea, crossing out of the old into the new, and begin to lay the groundwork of even as we move into 2022, God was challenging us even in that message, and even as we launch out into 2022, the importance of facing our fears as we move forward in this year. A lot of the things that have hindered us, a lot of the things that have allowed us to shake in our boots, God has given you the power. He's given you the strength to be able to face that fear, for we know God has not given us a spirit of what? Fear, but power, love, and of a sound mind. And we also learned even in that of the importance of even in the time and the day that we find ourselves in, of the importance of even as we face our fears, that it's time for the saints of God to step up, to stand up and be able to proclaim the truth of God's word, and to do that with a sense of boldness, and even in that, expecting to see the deliverance of God in situations. I know many times, you know, we look at things and we just say, oh, that's just the way things are, things will never change. But we have to come to a place that the word of God is true all by itself. And when we begin to proclaim, decree, and declare the word of God, there's an expectation that God will do exactly what he said. Do I have any witnesses on today? And so even today, as we move into the text that is before us, Paul here, the Apostle Paul, he writes this letter to the church at Philippi. And now he writes this letter in his response to them for his gratitude, for his thankfulness, for them supporting him while he was incarcerated in Rome. They're special to him because the Apostle Paul, he has founded the church at Philippi in 10 years earlier, and now he is coming back in a letter to be able to give them fatherly advice as they are moving forward. And Paul here, he points out early in the text, my first point, as we talk about moving forward this year, Paul points out in that, don't be discouraged because you haven't arrived yet. Paul says, even at the onset, even as we move and even as we look at what God has for us, I know as we cross over into 2022, and sometimes, you know, New Year's Day, we made New Year's resolutions of what we're going to do. Paul here talks about in moving forward, he points out the first point, and he says, don't be discouraged because you haven't arrived yet, when he speaks in verse 12 and 13 of the text here to the saints of Philippi. He says, don't beat yourself up in the present moment, because sometimes as we're looking forward, we can say, I know I'm not what I used to be, but I know that I'm not what I should be. And sometimes we become discouraged in that, because as we look back over our life and we see the time, and sometimes we say, we wasted a whole lot of time. And in that observation, we become discouraged because we think that we should be further along than where we're at. And as God is calling us forward, sometimes we get stuck in our yesterday. And so Paul says here early on, he lets us know, he says, don't be discouraged because you haven't arrived yet. That's good news, because even as we start this new year, the enemy was trying to say, well, you said you were going to do a lot of things in 2021. And the reality was you didn't do it. And so what makes us believe that you're going to do what you're saying that you're going to do this year? And Paul here, he points it out early in the text. When you read it, he says, not that I have already attained or am already perfected, but I press on that I may lay hold of that for which Christ Jesus has also laid hold of me. And then in verse 13, he says, brethren, he says, I do not count myself to have apprehended. Paul says, I'm not there yet. But yet he's about to drop some knowledge and some words of encouragement to the saints. Paul here, the apostle, Paul is saying in essence is, he says, I have not yet gotten to the place where I'm going to get to myself. But yet he understands the importance of, don't be discouraged because you haven't arrived yet. It does not negate what God desires to do in your life. So Paul here, the apostle, he lays the foundation and he gets us to understand. He was like, you have to know that God has not forgotten you. And Paul is saying, in essence, he says, I've not yet arrived. I've not yet gotten to the place where I think I should be. And he says, please, he says, don't miss this. It's Paul, the apostle, he says. You know, sometimes we're in a hurry to get to where we're going in life. And Paul here, when he opens up this introduction, we understand Paul to be one of the most spiritual, mature persons in the Bible, one who wrote most of the New Testament. But he realizes that in all of his accomplishments, everything that he's done, everything that sometimes people would brag and boast on, and even some of the things that we've done that we're not proud of, Paul says, I've not yet arrived. And now he communicates this realization to the saints of Philippi in his letter to them. And I believe this is an appropriate word, because there's some people under the sound of my voice who may find themselves discouraged even at the beginning of 2022. And Paul says, don't be discouraged. There's going to be some great things that God is going to speak to you. There's going to be some great things that God is going to bless you with this year. But at the very onset, he says, before you get there, he says, don't be discouraged that you're not where you should be. because Paul here, he communicates to them that life is a journey. He lets us know that we don't determine our present day situations to be a reflection of what our future destiny will be in Christ Jesus. Yes, if you look back in 2021, as I said on Watch Night Service, if we could testify that there are a lot of folks who would say, yeah, Pastor, I had to cry a whole lot in 2021. And some of us, we may have even experienced a lot of trauma and drama in our lives through the things that we've gone through in life. May not have even turned out the way we expected them to. You know, at the beginning of the year, we have an expectation of what we anticipate our new year is going to look like. And then as we've got to the end of 2021, we said, that didn't look like nothing I thought it would. And so Paul here, he speaks to it and he says, we're on a journey. We're all on a journey. And the reality is that even though things did not turn out the way that we wanted them to turn out in 2021, Paul says that God has you in transition and moving forward to the things that God has for you. And so God here, he speaks to them. And also even in this message of this first Sunday in 2022 through Paul's letter to the saints, God speaks to us to be able to encourage us and let us know, don't be discouraged because we haven't arrived. And secondly, God points out in the text here to encourage us in moving forward is we have to remember, you have to remember to forget your past. I said a lot right there because whenever you and I, whenever we're trying to move forward in life, the enemy will always replay your past. The enemy never shows your future because God's in control of your future. But what the enemy does is he will replay your past because he likes to replay all of your past mistakes. Whenever you're trying to move forward, he always hits the replay button. Because he knows that if he can get you to keep replaying the history of your past, it will keep you and I from taking steps forward in Christ Jesus. Because he knows you can't live in the present living in the past. The enemy knows that. So he automatically always tries to get us to replay the things that you didn't do right or what someone else did to you. You need to tell folks that's the past. And so Paul says here in verse 13, he says, brethren, he says, I do not count myself to have apprehended. But then he goes on to say this one thing I do. He says, I don't count myself to apprehend the things yet. I'm not there where I should be. So I'm not discouraged that I'm not there, he says. But with this one thing I've learned to do is forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things which are ahead. The Greek word forgetting means to let it go. Paul says, it's not as if, you know, it didn't happen. Paul acknowledges it happens, but in the Greek word of forgetting, it talks about let it go. Don't recall it. Don't keep bringing it back to your mind. Don't keep giving it life. If it comes up, don't give it energy. Don't give it life because life and death is in the power of the tongue. And some people can't move forward because they keep reflecting on what happened in their past and they keep talking about it. And the longer you and I talk about the past, we keep giving our past energy and life, and we fail to realize that energy that God has given us is for our today. And that's how the enemy paralyzes us with our past. And so Paul here, he speaks to it. He says that God has not called us to live in our yesterday. God has not called us to live in our past mistakes, but he has called you and I to live in the present day that he has made. And guess what? Also rejoice in it. The text says, forgetting those things which are behind. So even as we look back at some things that happened last year in our lives, as we're sitting here today, Paul says you have to learn how to forget those things which are behind. You have to realize those things no longer have the power to affect your destiny in your right now, because the past is the past. past. He says, those things that happened to you last year, guess what? That was last year. That's behind you. They are no longer in front of you, but they're behind you. And the only way that they can affect you is if you go back to the past instead of moving forward in the things that God has called you to. When we look back in 2021, just be real now. Look at now, I'm sitting up here preaching or standing up here preaching, and I'm not perfect in all the things that I do. Even as I look back in 2021, I realize we've all had some failures. We've all made some mistakes. We've all found ourselves in some mess ups. We've all even found ourselves in some situations where we regretted some of the decisions that we made. The problems, the pains, the issues, the challenges. We even lost some folk in 2021. We even had some challenges in the guilt and the shame from doing the things that we know God didn't call us to do, or the things we know God called us to do, and because of whatever reason, we didn't do what God called us to do. There's some shame in that, but as we crossed over in 2022, God gives us the opportunity to forget those things which are now behind us. Tell your neighbor, yes, those things did happen to you in 2021. But the good news is that that's behind you. Paul says, not only do I want you not to be discouraged because you have not arrived, but Paul says here in the text in verse 12 and also in verse 14, Paul says he presses. He's not to the place where God has called him, but he understands that in that this one thing he has to do, Paul says you have to learn to press forward. You have to learn to lean forward into the things of God. You have to realize press here, it means to pursue, to chase after so much that the thing that you're chasing feels annoyed. The thing feels persecuted because you just won't let it go. We just got a dog here a couple of months ago, Coda, and he's always around me. It's like, get out of my face. I just want to relax. But he's just pursuing after me because he loves me. I'm his master. There's a connection here. And Paul says that word here, pursue, it's the same, the press. It means that we pursue so much that the individual is annoyed. But even with that, it lets us know that word means not only to pursue, but also to flee. It's a joint word. That word means that you're running away from something, but at the same time, you're running away, you're also running to something at the same time. In other words, you're running away from the drama and the trauma of your past, and you're still yet running towards your destiny in Jesus Christ. And I know when God is stretching me. I know when God is stretching me because whenever God is stretching me, there's always something from my past trying to pull me back when I know that God is calling me forward. And Paul says here in verse 12, he says, not that I had already attained, he says, or I'm already perfected. He says, but I press on that I may lay hold of that for which Jesus Christ has also laid hold of me. This is what it means. It means the same way that Jesus pursued you is the same way that you and I should be chasing after him. Tell your neighbor, this year I want to be a God chaser. Because the reality is that God found many of us in some dark places. Oh, yes, he did. God pulled some of us off the streets. God pulled some of us out of the clubs. God pulled some of us out of the beds. Out of some nasty situations. And we found ourselves that we were all at one time in some places where we shouldn't have been. But Jesus chased us down and said, I still love you. This Jesus is like, what you're going through and what you find yourselves in, this ain't you. I got something better for you. And so he begins to call us out of darkness into his marvelous light. In that you and I, if we could be honest, and I know we won't testify, but if we could look back and we can realize we were in some places trying to run away from God. I don't know about you, but I grew up in a Christian home, and I was like, when I turn 18, I'm getting away from this stuff. Deuces, I'm out. I'm going to do me. I'm just going to live for myself. And that was my mindset. But God loved me even with that jacked up mindset. And even in some of the places that I found myself into, his love was still calling me. He was still pursuing me even when I didn't want to pursue him. I would be at clubs, and you know, you trying to fit in, you trying to do what everybody else is doing, you trying to talk to talk, smoke to smoke, drink to drink, all that. And these individuals didn't know you from Adam, but God knew your name. And God would use somebody in the room to say something like, "What you doing here? You know you don't belong here. And you don't know them from Adam." And you sort of like, "Wait a minute now, I'm in New Mexico, my mama in Illinois," and you go to look around like, you know, who done let the word out? That's because Jesus is pursuing us. And in our mind, even whether we're drinking, smoking, doing whatever the case may be, there's something that clicks and says, he's looking for me. He loves me. It brings forth that conviction. God loved us so much, and he pursued us, that no matter what you and I found ourselves in, nothing could separate us from the love of God. God loves us so much that he meets us in every dark place in our life to tell us, no, go ahead and cry your last tear. Get up out of here. Got something else for you. And whatever we found ourselves in, guess what? Jesus came and got us out of it. I know sometimes y'all look at me crazy and some of the things that I say, and because you say, "Well, Pastor, that ain't my testimony. I didn't go through all that." But we have all had moments in our lives where we found ourselves doing some things we know we didn't have any business doing it. But Jesus in his love didn't condemn us. He convicted us. He looked beyond our faults. And I said faults, plural. And he saw our need, the relationship. I don't know about you, but I'm glad he found me. I'm glad that even when I didn't pursue him, he was pursuing me. Y'all know my testimony and how raised in church and everything. And when I lose my mom at the age of 20, it devastated me. It crushed me. I cursed God. Didn't want to have anything to do with God or the church. And to anesthetize with pain, smoking, drinking, doing everything. And didn't even want to live, suicidal. But even in that dark place, it's where Jesus showed up. He said, "I got you." I said, "God, if you real, I don't want none of this fake church stuff. I said, if you real, I need you to do this for me." And that moment, I didn't come down the aisle. I didn't give my hand to the preacher. Didn't have time to go to a baptismal. Didn't get baptized in the Holy Ghost. But that moment while I was drunk, an instant sober, love surrounded me. I surrendered. I said, "Lord, here I am. Whatever you want me to do, I'll do it." From that moment on, folks ask, "Pastor, why you do what you do?" Because he found me. Because he pursued me. Because he saved me. Because he loved me when I didn't love myself. And now, with that same pursuit, Paul says, that's the same pursuit we ought to have for him. Paul says, "I want to lay hold on him just like he laid hold on me." And so in verse 14, he says, I'm pressing towards the goal. We're not just running away from our past, but we have a goal that keeps us pointed away from all distractions and detours. Some this year, even though they got good intentions, will have a difficult time, one, staying focused in 2022. And secondly, achieving those things because they don't have any goals. I know we left 2021, but if I could ask you the question, and you don't have to speak it, but internally, what are you really reaching for in 2022 on this first Sunday in 2022? Paul says, and I'm coming to a close here. He says, I do not count myself to have apprehended. But he says, the one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind, and reaching forward to those things which are ahead. It means stretch. God's calling you out, but he's also calling you forward. And so the body's in a stretch position. God says, I'm calling you out of your comfort zone. This is a season of stretching. You can't focus on what's ahead till you forget what's behind. That means this year, you may have to let some friends go and be okay with that and connect with people who are chasing after God. Not individuals who are trying to downplay the relevance of the Church of Jesus Christ in the present day. Not for those who are trying to redefine what God originally said. But you got to find yourself connecting with people who are chasing hard after God. So when you find yourselves in situations where people are trying to downplay the relevance of the Church of Jesus Christ, when people are trying to redefine, you're able to be wise as serpents and harmless as doves, and winning them to Christ Jesus. I'm done. I'm going to let you go early this first Sunday. This is a sign of good things to come. He said, Pastor, I didn't know you could preach under 45 minutes. This is a seed in 2022. But saints, and for those who are tuning in online, God is calling us to move forward. God desires not just New Beginnings Ministries of Peoria, but this is a message for the body of Christ, for us to go forward, not back. Paul says, I press towards the mark of the prize of the upward call. It's going to be some pressing moments. There are going to be some situations you don't feel like it, but you got to press. You got to push your way. You got to understand the upward call and the upward call that God gives us. God has given each and every one of us an upward call, and it's an invitation. It's a call from God. So don't, you know, sometimes we get a call on our phone and we be like, you know, you're in the middle of something and you pick up the call, I'll get to that later. I'll call them back later. But you can't miss this call. You can't miss this call. One of the worst things that you can do is to ignore the call from Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for our sins, was buried, rose again from the dead so that you and I can have life abundantly. God has extended to each and every one of us in here a higher calling. You are called, even on this first Sunday in 2022, as you're looking at what your 2022 is going to look like, God is calling you higher to what you currently see, and he's moving you forward. Stop being content on where you are. Tell God in 2022, I'm ready to move forward, Jesus. I'm ready to accept your will for my life. I'm not going to be discouraged. because I haven't arrived yet, because I've not done what I thought I would accomplish. I'm not going to live in the past and miss the life, the present. And with the same love and passion, Jesus, that you pursued after me, it's the same passion that I'm going to demonstrate this year as I move forward in Christ Jesus. Saints, God has called us to move forward. I don't know where you're at. Even as we start this year, Paul writes the letter. And he says, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to the things which are before. He says, I press. If you and I would be honest, and we look back in 2021, and there are a lot of things that we said on the first Sunday of 2021. And as life went on, the journey of life, the reality is we came up short. But Paul says, don't be discouraged. That's what God is speaking to you and I this Sunday. Don't allow the enemy to hold you in the past. Today is a new day. And as you and I forget those things which are behind, he challenges us at the same time that we're forgetting what's behind us. I'm reaching to higher heights, deeper depths in God. I want to be found pleasing in his eyes. So Paul says, you have to press. Moving forward, I know sometimes the Lord's going to bless you, and we go up in a shout. We run around the church. And I believe the Lord is going to bless you abundantly. But you're going to have to press. And what I've learned in my walk with God, when he's stretching me, it's uncomfortable. Sometimes it hurts. But it's working together for my good, because now I'm seeing the spiritual muscles that I didn't think I had when I'm being tested. You gotta press. You gotta press. And you've got to move forward this year. You can't be what you were last year. But you got to pursue God with the same passion that he pursued you. While you're standing, I'm going to pray for you this first Sunday. God's blessings upon you, and that God would give you the strength and the wisdom in moving forward in 2022. Father, it's even now, in the name of Jesus. We come realizing we can do nothing without you. Father, we thank you that you look beyond our fault and you see our need. And Father, even allowing us to cross over this first Sunday in 2022, you're calling us to move forward in you. Some of your people have had difficult challenges in 2021. that's trying to hinder them from moving forward in you. But Father, we speak even now in the name of Jesus, that where your spirit is, there's liberty. Every stronghold, every demonic assignment, every traumatic experience, Father, we speak to it even now in the name of Jesus. And as you make all things new, Father, cleanse, renew, strengthen them even now for the journey in you. Father, we pray even in 2022, clarity of vision, clarity of purpose in their lives. Allow no weapon that's formed against them to prosper. But I speak it even now in the name of Jesus. And allow us to pursue you with a renewed passion and determination, and to win others to Christ Jesus. Father, we thank you and we praise you even now in the name of Jesus. And the people of God said, amen and amen and amen. Say, God bless you in the name of Jesus. Are there any necessary announcements? Amen. You can be seated in the presence of the Lord, and we'll dismiss you momentarily as we say amen to the announcements in 2022.
Brothers and sisters, I want to welcome you back to life, back to the one that can make your next chapter.
Build your faith by joining the Pastor's Challenge in reading the Bible in 2022. Follow along monthly as we move forward in God's Word. Monthly reading assignment handouts are available at the information desk. Don't forget to pick yours up and start to move forward this year. This year, we will begin our church consecration at midnight, January the 2nd. We are asking members to consecrate and commit to either a Daniel fast or abstaining from food during the hours of 12 midnight to 4 o'clock p.m. daily during the week of January 2nd through the 9th. We will conclude the consecration on Sunday, January the 9th by partaking in communion. Thank you. Happy New Year, parents and youth. Mark your calendars for this month's YOD sessions on January 9th and 23rd. January's topics include new or old and reset. Let's start the year off right, diving into the Word. Attention, parents and young ladies. The Praise Dance Ministry is on its way back. We are enthusiastically looking for our youth to transform some of their TikTok moves and use them for the glory of God. All interested dancers, please give your information to Sister Renice. Not real superheroes.